This is very much an individual thing about starting these conversations. And if you can get these conversations to flow naturally, they're going to be a lot more informative. What we usually do in our hostel is if we lose somebody, we tend to have a memorial gathering for that person. And it's something that promotes a lot of conversation. And many residents will actually say, oh, I wouldn't want my memorial to be like that. So that's a great opportunity to start a conversation. So in working with one of my key clients, I may say to them, how did you find so-and-so's memorial the other day? Did you enjoy it? Did you think it reflected well on that person? Was there anything you would have liked to have seen there that they didn't have? Another very good way that's been developed with Ducky in our hostel is a game where we have questions written on pieces of card, and we take it in turns. We all play the game together, and some of the questions are light and funny. Some of the questions are much more leading. For example, we'll ask the question maybe, what would you like your legacy to be? Or we may ask, what's your favourite piece of music? So that we can start to get an insight into what that client really, really wants. The other thing that I've found very useful is walking and talking. You can often guide the situation. The other thing is that you're not sitting in a formal situation face to face. And sometimes as workers, actually, we might be giving signals that we don't want to be giving. If a client is looking face to face, every emotion is being seen. And sometimes it's easier to manage that side by side, walking. A lot of men find it difficult with their emotion, and they might feel tearful and they don't want to cry in front of you. But if you're actually walking, it's something that they can easily just hide. Certainly the practice nurses, the health inclusion nurses, have been very, very helpful. They're always there and they have a wealth of experience. And sometimes talking to them prior to a conversation is very good, because they can actually explain to you certain conditions. If you don't have any experience around that condition, those health professionals can help you understand in a simple way to help you communicate that to the client. They've also had much more experience in having these difficult conversations. So GPs, the health inclusion team, other key workers, even outreach teams, it's very important to talk to your colleagues about anything that they found is really, really helpful. So hopefully now this training will trigger a lot of conversations between workers, and hopefully workshops that are held with people will bring up a lot more good ideas.